coconut cream pie in the face has been a guaranteed laugh since the time of Laurel and Hardy. Maybe since humor began. Agreed?
Okay. Oh, Jesus.
Oh, come on, get it. Hit the brake. Hit the brake. Tony, hit the brake.
Jesus. Tony, that is not funny.
Precisely my point.
Whatever funny is, I've wanted it all my life. I want to be the cause of that dawning smile people get on their faces when someone truly funny comes into a room. Then, that unstoppable, cascading Niagara of laughs.
I want it because I know I haven't got it. I am not funny. I've known this for 40 years. Sure, I've gotten a laugh once in a while. I've gotten this close. But in comedy, this close is light years from the real thing. You can't be half pregnant, half nuked, or half funny.
Okay, got it.
Cascading Niagara of laughs? Where did that come from? Can we do this over?
No, no do-overs. Tony, we can't waste the film.
I don't think of it as a waste, exactly.
Okay, let's just move on. Now, we need your backstory so the audience will sympathize with you, okay?
Oh. Come on.
We'll just stay on you. No interviews, okay?
Well, look, promise me you'll keep it simple, okay? None of those still sequences, you know? None of those black and white publicity stills. Agreed?
Okay, you got it.
My so-called career began in the mid-60s with a comedy team called Hendra and Ullett. If Ullett was giving the interview, the team was called Ullett and Hendra. We arrived in New York one day in 1965, full of hopes and dreams.
Here, Hendra and Ullett.
Tony and I were married in 1965 when I was 5 years old. Well, actually, I was 18. I decided to come over on the boat with Tony. Well, it was an incredibly exciting time to be in New York. Anyway, I was drunk that morning. And hey, what if they turned out to be the Rolling Stones of comedy? Wouldn't that make me the Marianne Faithful of comedy? Chance to be a fine thing. Everywhere they went, they bombed. It was appalling.
From the BBC,
it was just agony
London.
Being out there in the audience.
New tests are being started to determine whether men are being illegally entered for the women's events in the 1968 Olympics. The doctors have declined to say what the test will be, but they hinted that it would include the word cough.
It was like somebody was feeding a baby into a buzzsaw or something. Of course, I was still in what we laughingly called love, so I blame the audience. But it wasn't the audience, it was bloody Tony. He stunk.
We had powerful managers with the clout to actually get us a shot on the Ed Sullivan Show.
And now from England in their taxi routine, Hendra and Ullett.
Thank you. Good evening. We have been living in New York now for about 3.5 years. And as you can imagine, we're getting fairly used to it. You know, we're getting used to earning, for instance, 3 times as much as our fathers do.
The audience was really quiet, almost reverent, as if they were watching bodies being removed from a train wreck.
Anyway.
Now Tony really started getting to me. I mean, I'd stuck with the bugger through 10 years of marriage, through thick and thin. No, forget thick, it was all thin. I mean, at least before he tried, he'd show some guts and get up in front of the punters, and now all he did was sweep fuck all. Goes for 20-mile walks along the fucking beach, talking to himself. And he eats all kind of weird Eastern shit from the fucking health food store. I mean, sometimes he'd stare off into space for fucking hours.
Perhaps what Einstein was saying is that God is humor. That the cosmic and the comic are one and the same. After all, there's only one letter's difference. What if comedy is an actual, tangible form of energy in the universe? A force that's been present in the universe since it began. Might even have caused the Big Bang itself. Which in turn may be why the Big Bang has always been a basic building block of comedy. But even if the cosmos is fundamentally comic, how are the saints of comedy touched by the god of laugh? How do you tap into this energy? Where is its source?
Canada. He wakes me up and yells, "Canada, Canada, they're all from Canada." Who's from Canada, I ask? The whole bloody cast of Saturday Night Live, half the writers, and even Lorne Michaels himself. Well, it's just a bloody coincidence. Get back to sleep, I say, but no. He has to go and ring another one of his school chums from Cambridge to find out the precise mathematical odds.
I always liked Tony, even though he and six other guys forced me to do their homework. So for old time's sake, I calculated that the odds of 11 very funny people being collected into a group, in this case an American television show, all being from one geographical area, in this case Canada, were exactly 6,014 to 1.
I mean, he figures that Canada attracts comic energy somehow, you know, the Northern Lights exposure to the pole or some such bullshit. The next thing I know, we're in a tiny twin-engine plane flying through a snowstorm to Saskatoon, which Tony picked because it was the funniest name of any place in Canada. And he won't sleep a wink until he's been sworn in as a citizen.
And her province of Canada.
There was absolutely nothing funny about Canada. Now came the Hollywood theory. Funny people converge on Hollywood from all over the world, so the funny must be really, really concentrated there. And he'd get himself nestled in real close with all these funny bunnies, and it would rub off on him like chalk or fleas or something. So stupid.
New York.
You know, the interesting thing about Tony is that even though he's not actually funny, he's always around things that are funny, which is, you know, odd, because you'd think somebody that was that close to funny things would somehow pick up the funny, and he never could. I mean, you know, if you look at Spinal Tap, you'll see that right after he said what he was saying, we get a big laugh. I mean, the laughs were maybe on either side of anything that Tony was saying.
They're not going to release the album because they have decided that the cover is sexist.
Well, so what?
Yes. But what's wrong with being sexy? I mean, there's no
sexist.
So here he was in a, you know, in a maelstrom of humor, and yet he himself not funny. Odd.
I can't figure out. Let's say I want a bite, right? You got this.
You'd like bigger bread?
Exactly. I don't understand how.
You could fold this, though. I mean,
then it's half the size.
No, not the bread. No, you can fold the meat.
Yeah, but then it breaks apart.
No,
like this.
You put it on the bread like this, see? Yeah.
But then if you keep folding it, it keeps breaking.
Why would you keep folding
it? And then
you'll,
everything has to be folded. And then it's this. And I don't want this. I want large breads.
See? You see how close to funny he got? That's as close to funny as you can get without actually being funny.
Anyway, that was it. I told him, sorry, Tony, old bean, but love is dead. D-I-V-O-R-C-E becomes final today. Me and little J. Oh.
Sarah, we don't really have the film for this.
Sorry.
Okay.
Well, anyway, I mean, the shit I'd taken from this guy. His unemployment had run out. We haven't had sex for 3 years, not that I'd noticed anyway. I hate his unfunny, untalented, on anything remotely resembling amusing guts. Okay, that's it. End of interview. Cut. I don't want to talk anymore.
Keep rolling.
Okay, we cut.
Yeah.
I mean, you don't realise how much I hate this guy.
I do now.
Where are you shooting this bloody film? Are you shooting it in New York? Dear New York? Where?
Well, around Long Island.
Oh, OK. Where?
Just around.
Oh. Yeah. Oh, son of a bitch. Do you think he'll make any money out of this? I mean, if he finds this funny quest thing, whatever it is.
Yeah, I guess he will, I will.
What, lots of money?
I don't know. Oh. No, I don't know.
There it is, Long Island. Fountain of yucks.
Within the marked-off boundaries of this map lie the childhood homes of six of the comedy megastars of our time. Andy Kaufman, Eddie Murphy, Billy Crystal, Howard Stern, Jerry Seinfeld, and Rosie O'Donnell. Now, what are the odds of that being a coincidence?
The odds of six comedy stars of such magnitude emanating from an area of a mere 10-mile radius calculates to 79,340,086,009:1. In this case, coincidence can be eliminated.
I believe that this portion of Long Island is the epicenter of comedy. Ground zero. I believe that if I can just put myself in the way of whatever substance, liquid, gas, food, lichen, or combination of environmental factors it was that made those six people so incredibly funny, I too can finally be funny.
Tony! Oh, it's me! It's me! Hi!
Sarah?
Hi, Jeff.
What? Hi, Sarah.
Did you?
No, I.
Are you responding?
No, no, you old silly. I've been following you for miles.
What are you doing here, Sarah? Well, we haven't exchanged a word in years.
They interviewed me for the film.
Tony, I thought it would be funny. I didn't think she'd actually come here. Come on.
I'll fucking kill you, man.
No, Tony, stop it! Calm down, sweetie, calm down.
Sweetie, Sarah, I don't want you in my film. I don't want you in Long Island. I don't want you in North America.
I can't believe this, man.
I really do admire you, you know, that you've stuck with this quest for the funny. You're like a modern-day Don Quixote. I always thought you were nuts. I was wrong.
I mean, you never thought I was funny, Sarah. You used to say, Tony, you're about as funny as a dead baby's open grave. You said it every morning for 15 years, Sarah. You know what she used to say? I want everyone to hear this. She used to say, the only funny thing you ever do is when you try to make love to me.
Oh, no, that's not funny.
Ha, ha, ha. Now, whatever the fuck it is that's on your so-called mind, get out of here, you'll ruin everything.
Oh, did you get married again?
No. Actually, it's us, you know. I can't get the fucking thing off. It's... Fingers put on a lot of weight.
Does it still have peace, love and alcohol inscribed on the inside?
It might. It might, probably, I don't know. I mean, it's probably rubbed off now. It's been a long time. Mm. Can't get it off, you know.
Mm. Don't know about the ponytail.
I like it. See, I thought when it came to it, it's like funnier.
Oh, really?
To have a like ponytail and all hanging down, all lank and loose.
Do you mind if I change it?
No, go ahead.
Take this out there. That's how I remember. Oh, the sweet, isn't he? Sweet with the hair down. Oh, what's all this? Blimey. That looks like it came from the Middle Ages.
Yeah, well, actually. Yeah, this did. This Did you see this? This is Ed Sullivan's laugh meter. You know, they found it when they did over the Letterman Theatre, you know, for Letterman.
Oh, does it work?
Yeah, I think so. Let me check.
What did you do?
All right, there it is. It's dead, right?
Yeah.
Now laugh.
Me, laugh?
Yeah, laugh. Go on. I know it's hard for you.
All right.
Give it a try. No, not some little titter like that. Come on.
All right.
A real laugh. Whoa!
Kill! Uh-oh. Kill!
More. It works. Go on. Killing him. You're killing him. No. No, Sarah. What the whole world thinks, isn't it? Tony, you are pathetically uncanny. What was that?
What?
She giggled. You giggled.
So?
You never giggle at me. Where were you standing?
I don't know. Somewhere here. About here. Here?
Yeah.
Why?
It could be the soil, I suppose.
What are you doing?
I'm seeing if there's any, like, subterranean water here or special kind of leaves or anything. Don't move, Dad. Don't move.
All right. What?
A tick.
A tick? Oh my God, you can get that, what's that called? That disease, that Lyme disease. You can get it. My friend got that. She was in hospital for about 9 months. You just fall asleep and you just don't wake up. It's absolutely horrible. Oh my God, has anyone got any spray? Oh, Jeff, there you go. Give it to me, please. Thank you. Oh my God.
Don't spray it, you'll kill the tick.
Sod the tick.
Sod the tick. This might be the end of my life's quest, and you say sod the ticks.
Well, I don't want to be bitten.
Oh, baby, come here. I love you.
What are you doing?
I'm just going to suck it up. I'm going to capture this tick.
Oh, no, don't get me there!
Oh, I got it.
What are you doing?
Well, I'm going to try it right here.
Are you kidding
me? Yeah. Oh, yeah.
What are you...
After all this time, are you kidding?
Oh, he's crazy.
Oh, man, Tony, no.
That's all right, isn't it? Oh, I can feel it. It's right in there. It's going up a bloodstream.
Oh, my God, I can't look.
Oh. Could be it.
Well, say something. Do something. Make me laugh.
All right.
No. If you're really going to be funny, let's try it on a pro in L.A. Just you, not Sarah. We'll use my miles.
Well, you know, I'm needless to say very curious about this because, you know, you can imagine the implications of something like this. If, in fact, being bitten by a tick could actually make you funnier, I mean... Think about what this would do to my industry. I mean, I'm making a film, I'm making a comedy. You know, I'd try to you know, gather as many of these ticks as possible, go out into Long Island and get them, and, you know, maybe whoever I'm working with, you stick a little tick on them, you know, maybe it's going to make them funnier. So, I mean, if in fact this does work, I mean, you know, I think, you know, there's a cottage industry right there just with the ticks. So, you know, I'm curious to see. Let's see what he can do.
Okay, Tony?
Hi, Rob. Mental floss.
Mental.
Mental floss.
Oh, I see what you did. Instead of dental floss, it's because it's like going through your brain or something. It's but mental floss. Okay.
Tony, I don't know.
Let me go.
All right.
What am I? I'm a zit.
What?
A zit. I say, has anyone seen my rake?
Okay, it's not the tick.
Scotch and soda, sir? Yes, sir. Right away.
And the reason you would be spritzing it at yourself is... Oh, that's the funny part, I see. That's the funny part.
Let's let Rob get back to work, okay?
Well, it's really hot in here. I'm really dying.
Tony.
You mind if I take off my jacket? Okay?
Listen, I don't know if this is going to be helpful at all, but I noticed that whenever I have dinner with either Jerry Seinfeld or Billy Crystal, doesn't matter where we eat, it could be Italian, Chinese, sushi, they always order Long Island iced tea.
Iced tea?
No. Long Island iced tea.
Long Island iced tea.
Yeah.
Maybe that's it?
I'm not guaranteeing, but, you know.
Okay. Well, I really appreciate it. Okay.
Long Island iced tea.
Long Island iced tea.
Long Island.
Thanks, man. Thanks.
Oh, Tony.
Yes.
Your sleeve.
Okay.
Your sleeve.
Thanks.
Okay.
Tony Stark.
Drinks, gentlemen.
One Long Island iced tea.
No. Wait till we get back to the island. Two Diet Cokes, please.